يا رب بليز اوبن استغفر الله العظيم واتوب اليه. استغفر الله العظيم واتوب اليه. ادريس اذان Estou com Bahia's granddaughter.
Because you want property there, 250,000 ringgit.
Bible, I think Arabian, and that's why most I found the why the most reasonable to land and make. Okay, and what? One day I say okay. No, Tutu. Your house? No. Your land? No. Your business? No. Be careful, my brothers and sisters. I'm not scaring you, I'm just telling you what Allah told you in the Quran. My job is to make it clear as much as I can. So, O Prophet Muhammad, meaning all Muslims, any comment to the Prophet actually is a comment to us. Strive hard against the disbelievers and the hypocrites. They are working for you, against you. And be severe with them. Their abode will be Jahannam. And worse indeed is that destination. Ayah very clear where the non-Muslims are going after death. Yet, you see Muslims trying to book them seats in paradise. Against the will of the one who owns paradise. Who is the one who owns paradise? Allah. He says who will go with God. He said non-Muslims will not go. I should worry about myself. Am I going or not? SubhanAllah. And by the way, paradise is not your house. For you to make anyone and say to anyone, no. It's Allah's house. Paradise is Allah's creation. He tells who should go, who should not. The Quran told us the believers will go, the disbelievers will not. So we go by that. Your house, brother or sister, let anyone come, you like. But not the house of Allah. Many Muslims have forgotten that Jannah belongs to God. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala clearly look, he said, وَمَنْ وَهَبْ جَهَنَّمْ أَلَّا تَطَرِّ بِهِ جَهَنَّمْ هَلْ. Who are they? Who are we talking about? Abraham. Who are we talking about? Very good. Hypocrites and disbelievers. Hypocrites, by the way, do they look Muslims or non-Muslims? Muslims. Hypocrites look Muslims. Yeah. By the way, the hypocrite is not a kafir. He will not be with the kuffar. He will be with us. That's why he's dangerous. He or she will be with us. That's why they are dangerous. Kafir will not come to the masjid. But a hypocrite will be done. He or she will stay and speak to you. Then, so Allah says, be careful of them. Now, examples of two wives, two women, sisters, who were very bad women. Although Allah gave them every chance to succeed. And another two women, who are very good women. Although Allah gave them challenges like no one before. So any sister who is going through any challenge, listen carefully. Two women, Allah gave them every chance to succeed, but they refused. They said, Ta'am. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala struck them in. Two other women, every hardship that you may imagine, they faced. Still, they made a choice. They will withstand by Allah, and Allah is over. Therefore, gave them paradise. Who are they? Let's see. Nasreen, go ahead. Verse 10.
Allah sets forth an example for those who disbelieve, the wife of Nuh and the wife of Lut. They are under two of our righteous slaves, but they both betrayed their husbands by rejecting their doctrine. So they, Nuh and Lut, benefited them, their respective wives, not against Allah. And it was said, enter the fire along with those who entered.
Very good. Clear, very clear. I like that. Allah sent examples, sisters and brothers, of two women who disbelieve. I mean, Allah has given an example to disbelievers. Two women. They were married to very good men. What do you want if your husband is a prophet, sister? If your husband is prophet, that's it. he chose him to be prophet, Nabi. Noah, alayhi salam, and Lut, alayhi salam. These two prophets were very unlucky with their wives. Their wives were not good. Don't say, alhamdulillah. Say, alhamdulillah, shukur. Takbir. What did they do, children? Children, imagine. The man is prophet. His wife ain't there. What does that tell us first? What does it tell us, brothers and sisters? What does it tell us? Very good, repeat. Very good. Being married to someone or being very close to someone doesn't make you, doesn't make him necessarily a good person. Another thing, yes, he can. Hidayah comes only from Allah. A prophet cannot even guide his wife. He cannot give Hidayah. No prophet gives Hidayah. Who gives Hidayah? Allah. Prophet gives da'wah. Prophet gives da'wah. But who gives? It's like we say that saying, you can take a horse to the water, but you cannot force the horse to drink water. You can take the horse to the river, but can you force the horse to drink? You cannot. If the horse doesn't like to drink, he will not drink. So our job is to take the horse to the river. Your job, my job, is to do that one. Do that one to people. I tell you, there is a class, discount, free. May Allah reward whoever sponsored. May Allah give him or her Jannah to feel. Say happy. Free dinner. What do you want more, Mr. or Mrs.? Everything for you to get some hidayah and knowledge in this message, still you don't want to come. But keep going. But if you go anywhere, you pay. But here, here's a plan of parking free. That's why from time to time, brothers, drop a few ringgits in the box. There is a box right here. Hey, that box shouldn't be there behind the ladies. Because they find it's good. Oh, because it's behind the ladies, that's why we can't go there. Put one bin here, and here, brothers, and one there. Takbir. Serious. You come, brothers, you are using mashallah, the street, the water, the light. From time to time. Or write a big check. Every 2-3 months, it's been a long expiation of my sins. Why not? Inshallah. Head, brothers. You die and you leave your money behind you. You leave it for somebody else to enjoy. Okay. So, what I was saying before? The box. Ah, you cannot force Hidayah on people. Here is an example. This is his wife. The mother of his own kids, he cannot guide her. So being prophet doesn't mean your wife will listen to you. I see. So two wives were very bad. What did they do? They cheated on them in which term? No, that doesn't mean they went slept with other men. No, Hashem. Allah will not allow prophet's wife to do that. Because the prophet will never sleep with a woman who commits zina. Even if she tries to, Allah will not allow her. But she cheated. They cheated their doctrines, their teachings. Meaning, you're supposed to be my supporter. In this that one. Not be against me. So they did not help their husbands, knowing that they are good people. Is there anything worse than this? Sister, is there anyone? Usually, by nature, a woman helps her husband. Even right or wrong. How about when she knows he's right? There are people like this. Two now, when it comes to Islam. So Allah is saying, do not be like one of these women. And this is not just for the ladies, it's for us too. That's why sometimes we see great people, their children are not very good people. Father is alim, talking, for some things. We don't say he should start with his children. to these two prophets didn't help them at all when that came. When Allah sent the angels to destroy those people, they were destroyed. We know the wife of Fir'aun, or the wife of Nuh alayhi salam, died where? Died where? Drowning with those who drowned. And the worst death is drowning. Two deaths are very bad. Ask Allah to protect you from them. Drowning and then you're burning. Which is the punishment of Fir'aun. In dunya, he drowned. And in Jahannam, Allah will punish him with fire. Same thing the people of Nuh. Allah drowned them and they will burn in there. Okay. So, Lut, alayhi salam's wife, was destroyed with the homosexual. Why? Because she tolerated homosexual. She was not homosexual, but she tolerated. It's okay. And she, subhanAllah, what she did? She went to the people telling them, hey, there are some handsome men in the house of Lut. Go get them. Very nice. Go see them. They're very handsome. And good. That, okay, we see you, don't worry. We're gonna see you very well. So they came. They came knocking the door. No, no, didn't we tell you not to hide any man if he comes to this city from us? We need to see them. See who? They said, the three men that are inside. How did they know? Because they came around Madrid and there was no one. Shame on you, lady. These are your guests. You should protect them. You should even cover them. No. Ah. Okay. One day came and they surrounded, besieged the house. Sayyidina Lut alayhi salam was furious. He went out and he told them, "Law annani, I wish I had power. I will finish it today. I will defend my guests in the end." Which is what Muslims need. You see, Islam without power, you must have power. What? I keep telling you this. Who said? Al-Qawi, one of the names of Allah is what? One of the names of Allah is what? Al-Quwat, Al-Qawi. Quwat, Allah is powerful and He loves that His slaves get power. Why are Sufis coming to Medina? In search of what? Power. So that he stops the nonsense. These people will not change by mere da'wah. 13 years, they are not going to change. So get the power, come back. Come back now, you become a prophet. Some people like this. Some people, when you tell them, please, brother, fear Allah, they stop even raising their voice. Show the power, any power. Okay. They got sin in that place. Even your children, when you tell them, son, eat, not to eat. You show a little power of the father of them. And as everybody sits in his place. That's why Muslims must have power. Whatever power means, could be money, could be politics, could be military, could be anything. Economy. We're losing. A lot of power. So these two women cheated their husbands. Not supporting, they worked against their husbands, who were doing nothing but good, spreading good. So what did Allah do to them? He punished them by being destroyed with the people, and therefore entered Jannah. Look, وَقِيلَ دُخُلَ النَّارَ مَعَ الدَّاخِلِينَ. Sisters and brothers, if two wives of prophets enter hell, what do you think of family? Women who share bed with prophets. They carry their children. Still go to heaven. So you think it's not the same who is fighting Islam and Muslims because they do some little charity here and there. Yes, Hassan?
Yeah, she heard that the people who drown
they
go to Jannah.
If they are Muslims, very good. Who goes to Jannah among those who drown? Muslim fisherman. From Sri Lanka, he goes to catch fish, he dies. This will go to Jannah. Not kafir. Kafir straight to hell. The condition is, you are Muslim, you went to halal, not the beach. You went with the human crocodiles and say halal. Serious. Not say you, I don't know where you went. Or in your swimming pool. What for pets have you done? Here? Or you save a life. You try to save a life and you drown. Here you go to Jannah. You must be Muslim first. But Muslims don't go to Jannah, whether they drown or not. Okay? They don't qualify. They don't have the Islam. You should have La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah. Then Allah may forgive you if you done drowning or burning or car crash or crash of building like earthquake. Okay? Am I clear now? So not anybody who drowns will go to paradise. Okay, good. So Allah says, وَقِيلَ الْأُولَى أَنْتَرْ both of them. أَنْتَرْ جَهَنَّمْ with those who enter. Two women of prophets. The amazing thing, sisters, brothers, look at this word. Look at verse 10. ضَرَبَ اللَّهُ مَثَلًا لِلَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا. Read with me. What's that word? ضَرَبَ اللَّهُ مَثَلًا. First step. ضَرَبَ اللَّهُ مَثَلًا لِلَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا. Mra'ata. What is mra'ata? Not wife. The woman. Pay attention. Look, when there is no love between husband and wife, even if they are men, they cannot be called husband and wife. They call me man of and woman of. The Quran is amazing. Look. Let's say we have husband and wife. Husband and wife. They can be physically together. Physically, they are together. They live in one house. They eat on the same table. But actually, they are not husband and wife. They are man and woman. That's why the Quran calls them. The woman of Nuh. He didn't say the wife of Nuh, because the wife means Zawja. Here is the word, Zawja. Zawja is wife. He used Imra'ata. He used this word, right? Which one is written there, children? This one or this one? Imra. Imra'a means woman of. Meaning all he gets is her body. He doesn't get her mind, her loyalty. She's not loyal to him. So brothers, check if your wife is a wife or, and if she is not a wife, check yourself, not her. Like me. No, serious, I tell you why. You could have done something that offended her so much. You could. And she could have done something that offended her. Because in this case, who offended the other one? The wife offended the husband. So all she got is his body. He was really, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala separated the relationship. That's it. This is the Quran, what mean? In some areas you find zawja, because husband and wife are good to each other. The heart is together. Mind is together and the body together. But why people just live body together and the one who's not necessarily they are happy? That's why the Quran said Mra'ata. In other areas, Zawja. See why Arabic is so important? He didn't say, ضرب الله مثلا للذين كفروا زوجة نوح وزوجة لوط. If he said that, it would be wrong. He said, Mra'ata. Meaning she was not really faithful to him, and she was not loyal to him. The wife of Noah, and also the wife of Noah. Do you see the difference? So when do we say Zawj? Zawj and Zawj, when do we say? Let me say the children, the parents, kids. Zawj, husband and wife, what do we say then? What do we say?
There is
Very good. When the husband and wife love each other and loyalty. He's loyal to her, she's loyal to him. This is called subjection. Clear? Imra'a and Rajul. Lillaki in front one. When you go to the toilet, do you find Lillaki in front one or you find the istri? What is like the Swami. Do you find istri, Swami, or Lillaki? Why do you find Lillaki? This is not for husband and wife. This is for males, females. Oh, I see. That's the beauty of Quran and that's the beauty of Arabic language. So there is difference between imra'a and zawja. And there is a difference between rajul, male, and zawja. Okay, alhamdulillah, we learned something new today. Shafiq, next ayah, 11.
And Allah has set forth an example for those who believe. The wife of Fir'aun, when she said, "My Lord, build for me a home with you in paradise, and save me from Fir'aun and his work, and save me from the people who are zalimun, polytheists, wrongdoers, and disbelievers in Allah."
Excellent. The super, 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 super duper best lady in the world. And first lady. There is no one more first than her, because she was the wife of the greatest king in history, who was crazy, unfortunately. Crazy, not mentally, I mean, morally. This lady, she had